the last series of investigative stories I did for mainstream journalism was a series called Dark Alliance, which I wrote for the San Jose Mercury News in 1996. And what Dark Alliance was about was a story about drug trafficking in the ghettos of Los Angeles and who was bringing the drugs in, and the fact that the American Central Intelligence Agency was indirectly profiting from this drug trade and knew about it and did nothing to stop it. And what my story's main point was, that it was this drug activity at that point in time that kicked off the crack epidemic in the 1980s. So that was a three-part series. We had a website, and it kicked up a shitstorm.
What was that shitstorm?
Well, I think the first revelation was that that crack happened in South Central LA for a very specific reason, rather than what was currently thought, was that crack just happened everywhere at once, and it was just black people, and they couldn't say no. And what my story showed was that the cocaine that was being sold in those neighborhoods was coming from mainly one source, and this one source was being used to finance a guerrilla war in Central America. And we showed it very conclusively that that was the case. And a lot of people, a lot of newspapers, then drew the conclusion that we were accusing the CIA of touching off the crack epidemic, which wasn't exactly what we were saying, but the general idea of the CIA dealing drugs was something that the American mainstream press had never written about before. And that's why it was such an outrageous story and a scandalous story. And the fact that we showed what happened as a result of this, which was crack in black neighborhoods. So it was an outrageous story. I mean, I admit it, but it was true. And that's why it prompted outrage among blacks, among drug reform activists, among politicians, by the CIA, by every federal agency involved in the drug war, because it showed they weren't doing their jobs, that it was a fraud.